bottles of Bronson Alcott, and apparently not a minute too soon. Here we are, not even through the first semester, and already seniors are pairing off in promontory anticipation. The jocks are jockeying for cheerleaders. The brainiacs are minding their own. Even the rodmen have found their rod women. Everyone seems to have someone, except pour moi. Here I am in my salad days with no fat, free, creamy Italian in sight.
Dee,
huh?
Have you noticed that people seem to be pairing off at an alarming rate?
Oh. Let's eat off campus today.
If I could just find a guy who's his own man.
Matt Damon in Good Will Hunting.
No, someone with an artist's soul.
Ethan Hawke in Great Expectations.
Someone who knows exactly what he wants.
Give it up, Cher. The man selection here is weaker than Urkel's uppercut.
So what am I supposed to do?
Cheer up and postpone. Soon we will be majoring in college, guys.
Maybe Dee's right. Maybe I'm destined to fly Han Solo until college.
I'm through with love.
Mark today as chapter one in the Cher Book of Abstinence.
Said adieu to love. Don't.
Wait a minute. Hold chapter one.
She is literally the Polaroid of perfection. She has everything and she'll give it to you in a second. Looks can't deceive. She wears her heart on her sleeve.
Just when I resigned myself to saying table for one, there he is, the Adonis of Alcott. But 2 long hours have gone by and I have yet to dialogue with this oh-so-prom-worthy boy. So I've sent Dee, an absolute pro, to do a little reconnaissance.
Contact. A long, boring Jodie Foster movie. This is fun. Next.
Dee!
Okay, his name is Bradley Hutton, and he's hot off the runways of Milan.
An international model.
He's huge in Europe. And as you can see, he's huge everywhere.
Oh, man, Zilla size doesn't matter.
Oh, God, check out those abs.
Ooh, any skeletons in the walk-in?
Nada. Our man rings the bell off the bell curve of dateability.
Well, well. I see Horrell and Lardy have discovered our newest student body.
Back off, Amber. Based on the rule of initial eye contact, Cher has an exclusive first look deal.
Oh, please, she can have him. According to this credit report, Brad's projected future earnings are respectable, but nowhere near Amber Bucks.
Amber, who cares about money when you are that speedo worthy?
Actually, I prefer boxers. I require extra room.
For what? Your butt? We're not talking about you, Pee-wee. We're talking about a real man.
As if we don't have enough trouble finding dates now, we gotta compete with that?
Please, you don't think there's some extra fluffing and stuffing going there? No, the guy's not wearing socks.
Look, socks or no socks, I have got to meet him.
You will.
Dream on, Rumble Sledskin. He is a major European star. The most beautiful women in the world have thrown themselves at his feet. No offense, Shara, plain and tall, but you need a scheme.
You do! Something elaborate yet undetectable. Something sophisticated yet accessible.
Hi, I'm Brad.
Excuse me, Brad, could you give us a couple of minutes here?
I'm Cher.
I think we kind of noticed each other this morning.
Yeah, I kind of remember that.
So any chance that we might be able to go out sometime?
Maybe.
How about dinner tonight?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Cool. Hey, man, can I bum a smoke?
Sure, dude.
What?
I'll see you later.
Bye. Murray?
What? So I have a cigarette every once in a while. What's the big deal?
Don't tell me you were smoking the whole time we were going out.
No, actually, dating you was the only bad habit I could afford.
How could you?
You know what? I'm out of here.
Wait! Wait a minute, Smokey. You and I are gonna have dialogue.
Can you believe him? What an idiot. God, I hate smokers.
Yeah. Oh. Some have so many other great qualities.
I don't care how well somebody fills out their Calvins. When it comes to dating, I have a strict no-smoking policy.
You're less. Cigarettes are sexy.
Come on! Some of the dreamiest, creamiest hunks in history have been puffers.
Requested 5 minutes. Make it good.
All right. Ah! These, my friend, are human lungs.
Man, turn yourself in. We'll get Johnny Cochran.
They're from the biology lab. Now, smoker. 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 Get the picture?
Hey, Einstein, frogs don't smoke.
Please. The Budweiser frogs hanging out in bars all day?
Grasping.
All right. Do you want to talk like this?
Sean, it's never going to get to that because I'm in control of this.
Yeah, until you're not. Please, come on, man. You're my best. Stop this before you can't.
I appreciate your concern, but there is no way that you, the Surgeon General, or his jackbooted stormtroopers will get me to quit smoking a second before I'm ready.
I'll tell your mom.
I'm ready.
Well, totally prepared to be overwhelmed by Brad's bodacious bod. What surprises me the most is his mind. He has one. And it works real extra good. Sorry, my brain's drooling.
So, what else about Europe? Where was your fave?
Oh, without a doubt, Paris. I remember this one time. I was walking along the Seine across from Notre Dame, and then this boat went by. And all of a sudden, its light struck this enormous tree, which was just above my head. And for a split second, it was as if there were hundreds of leaves, and they were just frozen in midair above the river.
It sounds beautiful.
Oh, it was.
So, after you're finished high school, will you go back there for work? Or will it be the inevitable Vendela model to acting transition?
Neither. No, modeling's just helped me save for college. Actually, I'd like to be an architect.
Really? Well, what do you want to build?
Are you a fan of Frank Lloyd Wright?
The airplane guy? No, those were brothers. Okay, say nothing, nod, and smile.
Well, I love the way that he combines nature and the home, and I want to do the same thing commercially. I've designed a coffee bar, and a river runs through it.
Ding, ding, ding. Fate alert, my two favorite things. Espresso and a Brad Pitt movie.
I love it.
Yeah? Now, most girls think that architecture is boring. All they want to hear about is all the juicy model gossip.
Oh, I want to hear all the juicy stuff, too.
Here's some inside scoop for you. Those models, they're tall, they're beautiful, and really hungry.
That's not a secret.
I know. But the secret is that not one of them can hold a candle to you.
Showing! Your table's ready.
The smoking section,
oh,
right?
Absolutely. Yeah. Is that okay?
I guess.
Right.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
few cigarettes smother this flame in my heart? Brad's the kind of guy I've always dreamt about finding. Break out the Haagen-Dazs. I have some serious thinking to do. It's horrifying. In the last 24 hours, I've spun from totally dejected to Happyville and back. Hello, Prozac police? I'd like to report a mood swing.
Dee?
Hi.
I can't believe that something as stupid as smoking might ruin this.
Oh, Cher, if that is the only thing standing between you and your Marlboro man, then you owe it to yourself to say something. Ask Brad to quit.
Yeah, right. How presumptuous would that be?
Hi, Brad. I know we've only been on one date, but I'm sure that you are so madly in love with me that you'll do this one little thing.
Sure. What is it?
Nothing.
Hey, I had a really great time last night.
I'm glad.
So, you free tonight?
Actually, I'm kind of busy.
Okay. Well, how about this Saturday? There's a really great party at the Rock and Roll.
Oh, well, could I check my date book and get back to you?
Sure. Look, Cher, normally I can take a hint, but, I mean, things really seemed to click last night, and I was wondering, is there something that you're not telling me?
Well, oh, please. I don't want to be a yenta, but yoo-hoo, Brad, it's the Siggies. She doesn't want to play Beavis to your butthead.
What? This is about smoking?
Well, I didn't think it was a big deal, but it really does bother me.
If that's all it is, I'll quit.
You mean it? What, you'd quit for me?
If it means getting you in the bargain, doing it for me. Last time.
According to the Smokeless Forever website, friend support and getting through the first 24 hours are the keys to quitting. Coincidentally, they're also the perfect excuse to pull an all-nighter. Notebooks included.
So how long is it going to take us to detox?
Most of the nicotine will be out of your system in 48 hours. And then, like most of your other problems, the rest is mental.
I have bottomed out. I gotta shake this monkey off my back.
You're a smoker too?
Worse. I chew.
Ew!
Take my pouch before it takes me.
I hate to ask, but
how? It's the age-old tale. Girl meets a rodeo clown. There's a barrel and a barn involved.
Too much information. You're in.
Oh, thank God.
Okay, we figure if all of you can hold your Jones till sunup, the rest will be easier than Celebrity Jeopardy.
Everybody, hand them over.
Now, in the spirit of the evening, I rented Trainspotting, Rush, and Evita.
I see the addiction motif on the first two, but Evita?
I like the costumes.
Okay, everybody, set your Cartiers. We will each take 4-hour shifts.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's kick some butts.
Yeah! Yeah. Kick some butts.
On three. One, two, three.
Kick butts!
People.
still smoke-free. Brad and Murray are showing more spine than that butt-revealing thing mini drive award at the Oscars. To celebrate, we're festing at Brad's rock and roll party.
Lots of temptation here for a dude 2 days on a nicotine wagon.
Yeah, but it's not a problem. Sean, even when I thought I didn't need you, you were there for me.
I always got your back, man.
Yeah, I know, but I appreciate it, and I just wanted to say, I'm not gonna let you down. You're like my no-puff daddy.
Have I told you how proud I am of you?
Well, maybe you should freshen my memory.
Now that's perfect.
A strike?
Mm-hmm. Never spare.
Couldn't shake it, huh?
It's not tobacco. But here's a little tip. Never order bowling alley shrimp.
Oh. That's just nasty.
Yeah, check it. Check it out. Second verse, girl. I know you think you never just a line. Ain't no getting putting up a fight. Cause my heart set on you. I see the truth that's in your eyes. I ain't fooled by your thin disguise. I can see it in your face. Girl, don't deny the way you feel. You know you gotta trust me. Trust. Give me a chance to prove I'm real. Oh yeah, yeah. Baby, when the lights go out, every single word.
Hey, Cher, where's Brad? He's up next.
Went to get me a drink. I'll fetch.
Again, you got the
owl. Babe, I swear you will succumb to me. So baby, come to me. When the lights go out, every single word cannot express the love and the mess. Show them what it's all about. Babe, I swear you will succumb to me. So baby, come to me.
Here you are. You're up.
Cher, wait.
I thought you quit.
So did I. I guess this is harder than I thought.
Well, maybe cold turkey isn't for you. I mean, there's the patch, there's gum, there's pills.
I don't know. I thought that I always called the shots with this.
Well, then let's try and beat it.
I don't know if I can. But what if I promise never to smoke around you?
Sorry. You have to make a choice. Guess you have. I knew smoking was bad for Brad's heart. I guess I didn't realize how badly it could hurt mine. Told you explicitly in this episode is don't smoke. In the end, that's your decision.
But we wanted you to understand that whatever your choice, this decision will have a major impact on your life. So be aware of a few hard facts.
Every day, more than 3,000 teenagers in the U.S. smoke their first cigarette. One third of these new smokers will eventually die of tobacco-related diseases.
42% of young people who smoke as few as 3 cigarettes a day go on to become regular smokers.
70% of teenage smokers say they wouldn't have started if they could choose again.
More than 400,000 people die each year from smoking-related diseases. That's more than from alcohol, crack, heroin, murders, suicide, car accidents, and AIDS combined.
So think twice before you light up.